Disciplined Agile is a toolkit. Now, you might have heard of this statement many times, especially the people who have some familiarity with the Disciplined Agile. And somebody might wonder, okay, some people call themselves frameworks, some frameworks are called themselves methodologies, and vice versa. And this Disciplined Agile is calling themselves toolkit. So what is this whole confusion is all about? Now, before I talk about it, I believe, it's a personal belief, that all these approaches, like somebody's framework, methodology, some research book, some toolkit, some knowledge, books people write, why they are writing, what is the utility of all these knowledge base for a person as well as for the organization or for the people who are doing work? So I believe these all methods collection should help us in improving our ways of working or finding our ways of working. So nobody can solve our problem. Say, if I want to run a business or if I want to start a business, nobody can give me a tip to how to run and start a business. Yeah, there is no recipe for it. But yes, there are reports, there are case studies which can help me to find out a quick path or maybe avoid some of the mistakes which others have already done. So that's at an individual level. And that's what I see is also a utility of all these frameworks, methodology, or a ways of working which are there in the industry. They all try to teach us how to run the business well and probably give us a way to run the software development value delivery at a faster pace. So that's something we are aspiring to learn fast. Now, then, some is framework, some are methodology, and few now Disciplined Agile call it itself toolkit. So I just try to see my interpretation of framework, methodology, and toolkit. And I do believe all of these things are targeting the same objective. Ultimately, we want to help the development team, the individuals, to find the best possible approach which can help them in solving their problem. And the sooner we can do it, the better it is, because the companies, the teams which are going through some struggle, they get a fast relief, and they ultimately need to own their own process. So that's the whole objective of be it a methodology, framework, or toolkit. That's what I believe. Now, in my understanding, the framework approach gives you a ready to start minimum process. It's like this, that you want to do a software development? This is how you should start. This is how you should plan. This is how you should go forward. And later on, whatever need, you can add to it. So it's like that we give you a quick start, and then you probably need to find what works for you, because nobody can give you the exact solution. And that is how your ways of working will evolve. Ultimately, maybe after a few months of following a particular framework, your ways of working will be owned by you rather than the recommended by the framework. Yeah, because that's something we are aspiring to do, and you need to improve your work, not a book work which is there somewhere. So framework gives you a quick start and then help you to inspect and adapt, and then you find out your own process. Now, methodologies looks like a very bad name in today's world. People try to think that methodology is something is very detailed and it tells us what to do and what not to do. But I personally believe the methodology gives you a ready to start detailed process. So rather than giving you a minimum process, it gives you all possible detailed process. This is how you should work. And then it tells you going forward, you can reduce it. You can tailor it as you need. So we give you the all possible best way of working. More and more fine-grained steps are defined. And many of you who have worked in the software development environment, you might have seen all these things, especially in your own organization, where you find that these things are there. So this is something which helps us in giving finding us a ready to start process, and then we can tailor it as we need. Yeah, tailor means that you might reduce, you might change, and the continuous improvement is always needed. Be it a framework, be it a methodology, you can definitely need to follow it. So now the toolkit approach. So raising hand, writing a question will be a better option than the raising hand, because it will be difficult for pause and take a question, but please put it into the text box. Yeah. Now the toolkit approach, which we can see the Disciplined Agile is talking about, it is saying that, okay, let's give us a lot of ideas. Let's create, give people various process, various options, which are there as a guide. And then people can create first level of process based on their context. So it's like this, that I have a knowledge base, then I look at my problem, and based on my problem and knowledge base, I put these teams two together and I come up with my first level of process, which, so here there is no direct quick start. Here is no direct jump start. It is something that coming, yeah, coming as a part of your collection of ideas are there, but then those collection of ideas need to be looked into and you need to create your process, and definitely inspect and adapt is always there. So ultimately, I believe, be it a framework, be it a methodology, or be it a toolkit, ultimately, as a owner of the process, I am the owner of the process, and I need to own my ways of working. And all these approaches, some organizations, some people may be familiar and comfortable with the one way of working or another way of working, but ultimately, after a few months, we need to have a maturity where the development team, the consuming organization start owning their process. And that's the whole idea of helping you to develop your ways of working. Now, we can say that, okay, then this is something understood. Maybe some of you may agree, some of you may disagree, but this is something like I am sharing my approach. And then you may say, okay, then ultimately, what is discipline agile then? So this is like a formal definition of discipline agile, which is coming here. And it is telling, it's a very much like a toolkit, not a framework, and focuses on giving you a decision framework, which helps you in considering your need and a various available option. And what are the advantages and disadvantages associated with those options, so that you can come up with your first level customized solution in the beginning itself. So the DA approach is usually you start with either minimum framework or you start with a detailed framework, but it takes time to mature the minimum framework, to tailor or cut out the detailed framework. So what we are telling you is that we have the all industry knowledge, we have created that particular knowledge base. Why don't you few people initially sit together and create something which is suitable for you in the beginning itself, and definitely you can improve as you go along. And in their understanding, this toolkit approach can faster, like can speed up your journey of reaching to the desired ways of working. And that's what the Discipline Agile toolkit approach is all about.